Hi everyone, my name is Sarah, and today I'm going to be making the character Stevonnie from the show Steven Universe. This character is a fusion of two characters, Steven and Connie. Recently, in an advertisement, Stevonnie was confirmed to be intersex and non-binary, and their pronouns are they, them. So I've had the idea to make a Stevonnie doll for almost as long as I've been customizing dolls, and I knew that I wanted to use a Moana doll. Her hair is nearly perfect to be Stevonnie's, but the hair that she's rooted with is a bit sparse and is pretty matted at the end. So I cut it all off. This doll's head is definitely thicker than a Monster High doll or an Ever After High doll's head, so it needs to be soaked in boiled water for longer to soften the plastic enough to separate the head from the body without damaging the neck peg in the process. You will need to go slow but give a firm yank to get the head off, and then spill the water all over, burning yourself. Well, you might want to skip that part. The neck hole is too small really to remove the hair, so I slit open the back of the head in between a line of plugs and scraped out the hair and the glue with a pair of pliers. To seal up the cut in the head, I decided that instead of sewing it, which is pretty common, I was going to use my Loctite flexible adhesive. If you're going to use glue to seal up a head as opposed to sewing it, you're going to need to use a glue that is flexible and bonds to plastic so that it will survive the rerooting process and be sturdy for a long time. While the head dries, let's work on the hair. I wrapped the yarn around a sketchbook that was twice the length I wanted. Then I cut the yarn loops at just one end. The final step in preparation was to untwist all of the plies or strands of the yarn. This will give me a thick, curly yarn, just like Stevonnie's hair. Now that the glue is dry, we need to clean off the factory face paint with 100% pure acetone. Now it's time for the reroot. Fold the yarn ply in half across the finger and scoop it up in the middle with the needle of your rerooting tool. I started with the hairline. Normally, when you reroot with yarn, you won't want to plug every hole, but I wanted Stevonnie's hair to be thick, almost exaggeratedly so, so I plugged every hole. Once the head was fully plugged, I dripped in some galaxy glue from the doll planet. I spread it around inside the head with a knitting needle. The head is so stiff and small, it makes the nooks and crannies harder to get to, but it's important to get all of the plugs glued. For the face, I began with watered down acrylic paint for the scleras of the eyes. This is where I map out their shape. Stevonnie's eyes are very different from Moana's, and I was worried that the sculpting of them on the doll would make it hard to get the right shape. But once the first few layers were dried, the molding on the doll receded and the paint created the eye shape itself. Since this doll came without any clothing and their body type is unique to all of my other dolls, I spent some time trying on some spare clothes to see what fit. This would help me decide what size to make the patterns for their clothing. In the end, I decided on using the patterns I made for my Mini-Me doll, with some modifications, since this doll is slightly slimmer than my Mini-Me. At this point, I decided it was better to put the head back on now before I finished the face up. I wouldn't have to worry about anything cracking this way. Since the plastic was so stiff, I had to reheat the bottom of their head with hot water and even carve away a little bit of the plastic. That part probably wasn't entirely necessary, but I panicked. The next step was the lines around their eyes. I used one of my tiny detail brushes for this and a very dark gray paint. I worked slowly, trying to remember what I had learned from my Hilda custom. Since I've moved, I have a new setup and I'm trying to find some nice camera angles. Clearly, this one has too much of my head in it. I'll get there eventually. Pupils were next. Stevonnie doesn't have any irises, which felt weird, but I got used to it. I gave them a slight side glance since there was less detail. It makes dolls with eyes like that less creepy, I think. I gave them some blush on the cheeks with a darker red, trying to create a slight sunburnt look. I kept the contouring minimal to match the simple art style of the show. I made the shadows in their eyes heavier than I normally would. Since their eyes are so flat, it helps to give the illusion of depth, something I also tried in Hilda. A lot of what I did with Hilda I transferred over to this doll. After a layer of sealant, the next step was to add some shines to their eyes in the form of small white blobs. I originally intended to make them circles, but I messed one up, so they turned into ovals. It took me a bit to realize that they were missing their eyebrows. I knew something looked off. So they didn't get put on until the very end of the face-up. Of course, I hadn't waited for the paint to dry, so I ruined the eye shines and had to redo them, as well as the first attempt of my brows that I had been trying to remove anyways. Once I had sewn up the red crop top, I added the star to the front using yellow acrylic paint. I know some purists out there are gasping in horror and speeding to the comments section to complain, but honestly, it's my doll, and I'm doing the best with what I have and my abilities. So, it doesn't really matter, I don't think. If you're going to paint something onto a piece of doll clothing, I definitely recommend sketching it out first. You don't want your logo or design to be lopsided. I painted the fly detail onto the jean shorts as well. When sewing the legs of the shorts together, I folded the edge up at the same time. This would give them a rolled look and keep the legs rolled to the same length permanently. Then I hand-stitched up one leg to the crotch and then down the other, before sewing up the back seam. I trimmed the strands of their hair to create a round edge, similar to how Stevonnie's hair is in the show. I decided as a special little extra detail I'd add sand to their feet. A lot of the show takes place on the beach, and one of my favorite Moana dolls has sand on her feet, so it all ties together in my mind. I mixed up a sand color of some undiluted acrylic paint and splattered it onto their feet and up to about their knees, with the highest concentration being at their feet. The last thing I needed to make, and the part that I was the most nervous about, was their gem. I made the first mold, which you can see me making here, out of air-dry clay. But I ended up remaking it later with polymer clay. I made it against their abdomen instead of my work surface, so that the final gem would sit flush with the doll. I mixed equal parts of A and B of a silicone mold-making putty together and then pressed the gem into it stomach side down to retain the shape of it. I was using UV resin, which shouldn't work with opaque silicone like this, but I was hopeful I could kind of force it to work. Once the mold had cured, I popped out the gem and added the resin along with some chalk pastel for color before mixing it together in the mold. I set up my UV grow light for my plants with its two heads angled into the mold, hoping to get all the parts and corners and nooks and crannies of the resin that wasn't directly exposed. I tried my best, but when I popped it out, it was only partway cured. It might have worked if I had let it cure for even longer, but I didn't really want to waste the resin to find out. So this time I made the mold with the larger side facing up. The gem wouldn't sit flush to their body anymore, but it should cure fine with a light shining straight down onto it, since it's so small. This time it did work. When I popped it out, I sanded and buffed every facet with a nail buffer. After letting it dry for the required 3 hours, I superglued it to the doll. There are gaps between the gem and the doll, but they aren't too noticeable. It looks like a fruit gusher. Then it was time to get them all dressed. I can't wait to see how they look. It turned out great. I love Stevonnie as a character, and I think this doll really captures their personality. I was worried that the base doll looked too much like Moana to really be used for anyone but her, but I was wrong. The posability of this doll, with its chest articulation, made creating dancing poses a breeze. I think Stevonnie's outfit is possibly the best one I've made yet. I'm starting to get pretty competent at making doll clothes. I've never used resin before either, and I think it was worth the extra time and effort to make a gem that looked like a real gem, or a fruit snack. I'm so happy with how they turned out and how I edited the video. I'm always trying to improve. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a suggestion for what you think I should tackle next below this or any video for a chance to be featured in an upcoming series. I hope you all enjoyed and that you're having a great evening, morning, whatever it is. I hope it's a good one. Bye!